Just create it again so we can see. So go to the layer, solid, and what I'll do, I'll just create it from the first one. So go to the composition, new composition, make it 200 by 200, frame is 300, hit OK, right click, new, solid, as simple as it is, rename your layer. Then what I'm going to do is I'm just trying to create a glass type effect. It should look like a glass box. So for that, I'm going to apply two masks. One is for the outer edge and one is for the center. So to apply a mask at the outer edge, just click at the rectangle 2, rectangle mask 2, select it and double click it. When you double click it, automatically the mask will apply to the edge of the layer. So this is the first mask you need to apply. For the second mask, I'll take the ellipse, select it, I'll go to the center. Now this is a tricky part, so just remember, go to the center, drag your mouse and hold it, don't leave your mouse. I want to bring this circle to the center, so drag your mouse, don't leave the mouse, then press Ctrl and Shift. Automatically the mask will jump from this place to the center and it will have a perfect circle. So again, just drag it, doesn't matter what shape it is, press Ctrl Shift. Automatically it will form a perfect circle and it will be from the center. Make sense?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Go to the second mask, which is the ellipse mask. I'll make this from add to subtract. As you can see, there is a transparency created. I'll open the mask 2 property. So go to the mask feather and increase the mask feather. And remember, all the masks are applied here. Now, sometime when you are working for the first time, you won't be able to, you will forget to select this layer. So what will happen? When you try to drag it, it will create a new layer. This will happen to you guys. Just make sure you are selecting the layer and applying the mask on the same layer. One more thing, when you are working with this composition, make sure you have a square pixel. I'll tell you why later, but just make sure pixel aspect ratio should be square. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Now, for the outer mask, I'm going to apply a stroke on it. So I'll go to effect, generate, stroke. Okay, and I will just increase the size here. So there is a stroke also. Okay, now you got a two option here, leave all the attributes and move all the attributes. Now what are attributes? Now to understand this is very simple. Attributes are all your position, scale, rotation, opacity or effects. Anything you apply to a layer is called attribute. So for example, if I take this apply effect, just for argument sake, say if I go to color correction, apply hue saturation, okay, and I change the color here. I can change whatever color you like. I can select the layer, I can go to the layer and I can pre-compose it. Okay, say for example, layer, pre-compose, and I say leave all the attributes. What is going to do is going to bring all the effects at the top of the pre-comp layer. As you can see, there are no effect inside this comp, but all the effects has been bounced back to the main comp layer. Now, if I select this layer again and pre-compose it and I move all the attributes, pre-compose it. Now, as you can see, there is no effect on the comp layer. It's inside, it's still remaining inside the comp layer. Now, what is the advantage and disadvantage? So, advantage is like if I duplicate layer, say, 3-4 times. Okay, remember, I have move all the attributes, not leave all the attributes. So what will happen if I go to one pre-compose and I want all the four colors to be say a different color from cyan to say red color. If I change it in one pre-comp, it will update in all the four com. When you put move, when you use move all the tables. Now obviously you can understand what's the disadvantage of it. The disadvantage will be anything you change inside this parameter will affect all your. Okay, so the last one is your 3D layer. If you are not able to see this, you can just toggle the switch mode, click it, and you will get a 3D. Now if I just open a position, you can see when I apply a 3D layer, you get the third axis. As you are doing a 3D software, you know there are three axes in 3D coordinates, x, y, and z. X is for horizontal shift, y is for vertical shift, and z is for depth. Okay. Now, to create a 3D box, we need a different perspective mode. As in Maya, you use a orthographic mode. Like if I go to custom one here, these are the orthographic mode, just like Maya. If you want a multiple window, just like Maya, you can change it to the four views, two views, and whatever you like. So I'll just go with one view. I don't always like to work in one. Depends on the point. So I'll take it as a top layer. What I want to create is a 3D box. So for that, what I'm going to do, just drag this first layer to the edge of this corner. Duplicate the layer, Control D. Drag it up. Control D. Bring it in the center. Now you can do a rotation. I want to bring rotate this in a vertical way. So you can do a couple of ways. You can rotate it. Select the layer. You press R. You can rotate it by going here to the y-axis. Make it exactly plus 90, minus 90, doesn't matter. Or you can press W, or you can go to here. The rotation tool. Bring this cursor to the center, and if you click and drag, it will rotate. If you press shift and drag, it will snap to the 45 degree. Okay, both are correct, whichever you like. If you want to use it, go to the rotation tool, hit shift and drag your mouse, it will snap to the 45 degree angles. Or you can directly put a 90 degree. Now, as you can see, when you use the rotation tool here, you can see the changes happening in orientation, not in X, Y, Z. Both are same. We'll talk about this later, maybe in the motion graphics session. What's the main difference between? So it's up to you. You can change it from here or you can change it from there. Doesn't matter. I'll make it just 270 exactly. Then again, I'll take the move tool. I'll press shift left arrow. I'll just zoom in and see the lines are not going outside. As you can see, there are some mismatch. Just fix it. I'm using up arrow, down arrow keys. And then I'm holding a space bar, pan around. Okay, so once I'm done with this, and for argument's sake, I'll just create a two views. You just create one view, don't create two views. It will be. So as you can see, what's happening around this area. So I'll get this wall again duplicated and move it. But so once you're done, you have for the final render, you have to always be in active camera. Okay, so just make sure you are at that. When you are done with creating, say, creating a project, just come back to the active camera. Don't be in custom viewer. These are not your render area. So your render camera is active camera. Now, as you can see, when I came to the active camera, you can see I'm not able to see the full box. Now, simple reason is my composition size is very small compared to my project. So once I've done with creating the box, I can go back to the composition setting and increase the size to 900 by 500 and whatever size you like is up to you. First thing I'm going to do is just move the anchor point from center to the bottom, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate it along this axis. As you can see, if I'm rotating, it is rotating from center, not from the bottom. So to do that, select all the layer, press A for anchor, go to the second parameter, which is your Y axis, and try sliding up. As you can see, the anchor is moving down. Obviously, your object will move up. Okay, once you're done, press position and bring it down. Just bring it at the bottom. So once it's done, now I need to animate this flippers. So I'll press U, R for rotation, and say if I want to rotate, I have to rotate this X axis. So on zero keyframe, I will apply a keyframe, move to 30 frames, go to 30 frames. And I think my composition FPS is 25. So I'll create it on 25. Just zoom in. I'm zooming in from here. And I'll type 90 degree. I'll move 50 on 50 frame and apply a hold keyframe or add keyframe. I can do it by copy and paste the previous keyframe, or I can apply this. Add keyframe from here. What it will do, it will just duplicate this keyframe automatically here. Now why I'm doing this, I just want key from 0 to 25, it remains, it's animate, and then from 25 to 50 it remains at this position, and from 50 to 75 it go back to its previous position. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I'll press U again just to see the keyframes. Let's go to the next rotation. Same thing, I think it will be on the X only. So let's check it out. Yeah, it's happening on the X. Let's go to the next keyframe. So if you have reveal a keyframe above your layer or any below your layer, you want to jump from this keyframe to this keyframe, you can press K to move forward, jump on the forward keyframe, or J to move backward on the keyframes, jump on the jump backward on the keyframes. So J and K, these are very helpful. So I'm pressing K, jump from this keyframe to this keyframe. In this case, I think I have to apply minus 90 because it's facing in opposite direction. Okay, let's come to the 50. Again, I will apply a hold keyframe, go to 75, and bring it back to 0. Okay, let's move to the next layer. Rotation. Rotation, and now this time let's see which axis it does. This axis only. This line. So again on the X axis, keyframe, K, minus 90 I guess, add keyframe, 0. Yeah. So rotation again, keyframe, I guess plus 90, next keyframe, add keyframe, and 0. So you will have this animation happen. Okay, so once I'm done with here, so this looks cool, right? We will proceed later on this. Now, what I want to do now, I want to rotate this box. So I'll create a new null here. I'll bring it up. Make sure it's also a 3D layer. Select all the four layers, the wall layers. Parent with the null layer. So now I'm parenting it. Select all the four layers. You can see this. These are called pick whip. Drag it and connect it. As you can see, when I drag and drop this, the name changes from none to null, or select all the layer and type null. Select null. You'll get the same result. And what this null will do, select rotation, go to the y-axis, let's go to the 100 frame or 75 frames still the animation. I'll put one full rotation here. If I move. And to finish it off, for example, why did I create a pre-composition? I'll open any length. You can open any of this length, doesn't matter. I'll open it and say, if I type a text, you can see it has applied text to all the layer. Cool. Or what we can do, I can give you a file. I will send it. Send you the file here. Actually, I have very good collection. So let it doesn't matter. Take this flourish. I can only send you right now one. And I can go to inside a pre-compose. I can move this text. And if I just move forward, you can see something is animating, but you're not able to see because the size is very large. So I'll press S and bring it down. Okay, I do a rotation here. If I go to this comp now, you can see something is animating on this. It looks cool.
Yes.
I want to make this little slower. The flourish, when it's going, the flippers are going down now. All the animation are happening at this particular time only. And when it's coming up, the animation is done. So I'm not able to see any animation on this flourish. So to make it slow, to animate it slow, what you can do is, right click on this parent link column and you can see an option for the stretch and choose a stretch and then you can stretch your time, which will slow the video animation, which will help us to achieve some good animation. Yeah, this looks much better. I can keep playing if I change here. Perfect.